啊，好，外坤特知音服务源于聆听，各位尊敬的奉献者，今天是2024年10月29日，我们又非常荣幸的邀请到圣巴克提维维纳什纳辛哈玛拉跟我们讲今天的早课，敬请聆听，Hare Krishna。
Om Gyana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpataruvyascha Kripa Sindubhayeva cha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, the second part, and we're hearing about Gop Kumar, who is a cowherd boy from Govardhan, and how, by the power of the mantra given by his guru, he's able to travel into the spiritual world. And he came to Vaikuntha. And from Vaikuntha, they sent him first to Ayodhya, and now he's come to Dwarka.
我们今天继续聆听《大博伽瓦谈甘露》这本书的第二部分，讲的是哥尔丹山的一位牧牛童哥帕库马尔，他的 guru 赐予他一首 mantra，集着这首 mantra 的力量，他得以旅行到灵性世界。他首先去了维昆塔，之后他又被送到阿尤迪亚，现在他来到了朵尔卡。
So when he came to Dwarka, he was well received. And the Lord of Dwarka, Lord Narayan, personally wanted to meet with Gop Kumar. And he was asked to come cl forward to be with the Lord of v Vaikuntha, the Lord of Dwarka, rather.
所以他在朵尔卡城就受到了非常热情的接待。朵尔卡的主人，就是想来去见勾帕库马尔。
So the Lord Narayan was with all of his wives and his two mothers and all of the queens who were his wives.
就是哪样呢？和他的妻子们，他的两位母亲，还有朵尔卡城的皇后们在一起。
So they surrounded the Lord Narayan, and the Lord Narayan entered into his own palace, and he was followed by groups of his young sons.
这些人都簇拥在主拿让的周围，陪同他进入到了宫殿。他的一群一群的年轻的小儿子们也都尾随着他的身后。
So the Lord of Dwarka, Lord Narayan, he sat down on his throne, and he was suppressing the feelings which he had, which were because of meeting Gop Kumar.
朵尔卡的主人拿让呢，坐在了一个宝座上，他抑制着内心的情感，他因为见到了勾帕库马尔，内心激情澎湃。
Yeah, because Gop Kumar, remember, he's a cowherd boy from Govardhan, and Lord Krishna, Lord Narayan who is none different from Lord Krishna. He remembered all of the Leela there in Vrindavan, in Gokula, in Govardhan. He remembered all, and it agitated the mind of the Lord.
要记住，格帕库玛尔可是来自于噶尔丹山区的一位牧牛童，所以和 Krishna 没有分别的朱拿拉呢，便联想起了在文达文、格库勒、噶尔丹山的逍遥时光，这些都使他的心意感到激动不安。
So Lord Narayan wanted to please his mother, Devaki, and the queens, and he also wanted to make sure Gokumar was in a good mood. So he appeared very happy.
朱娜娜呢，和她的母亲 Devaki 和她的众多皇后们都纷纷的在一起。她希望戈帕库马尔处在愉悦的心情当中，能戈帕库马尔来到这里能感到快乐。
Just by the presence of Gop Kumar, it was taking the Lord back to his childhood pastimes, and it made him feel very happy.
仅仅是戈帕库马尔的临在，就把主带到了他孩提时代的逍遥时光，使主感到非常的快乐。
So Gop Kumar saw the Lord in front of him, and he saw the Lord along with his mother, Yashoda, and all the other beautiful young gopis and the cowherd boy.
戈帕库马尔，他现在看到主在他的眼前，他的母亲雅舍的，还有那些美丽的年轻的勾皮们，那些牧牛童们，也都在他的眼前。
So Gop Kumar, he was a devotee of Madan Gopal, and that it was ob object of his meditation to see Madan Gopal holding a flute in his hand. So when he saw Krishna holding a flute in his hand, then he fainted. It made Gop Kumar very happy.
Gopal Kumar 是 Madan Gopal 的奉献者，在他的冥想当中，Madan Gopal 总是手里拿着一只笛子。现在，当他看见主 Krishna 手拿笛子的样子，他在快乐当中昏了过去。
When Lord Krishna is in Dwarka, he doesn't carry a flute. And
当
Gop
主，
Kumar, he was worshipping Krishna holding a flute.
在 Dwarka 城的 Krishna 手里没有笛子，但是 Gopal Kumar 所崇拜的那位 Krishna 是手拿笛子的样子。
So this mood in which he Gop Kumar was seeing Devaki, he saw Devaki as Mother Yashoda. And he saw Krishna's queens as gopis. And he saw his own sons like they were cowherd boys.
在，Gopa Kumar 的心绪当中，Devaki 就是亚洲的母亲，而 Krishna 的皇后们就是那些 Gopi 们，还有 Krishna 的儿子们就是那些年轻的小牧牛童。
Yeah, because Krishna had taken Gop Kumar's flute and he was holding it in his hand. So that caused Gop Kumar to feel ecstasy and to remember everything in Vrindavan.
因为早先的时候，Krishna 把 Gopa Kumar 手中的笛子拿了过来，所以 Gopa Kumar 在狂喜当中不禁联想到了 Vrindavan。
So, in Gop Kumar's ecstasy, he saw Krishna remaining as beautiful as he always was.
Gopa Kumar 在狂喜的心绪当中，他看到了他长久以来一直冥想到的美丽的 Krishna。
And he saw Balaram's mother. Balaram's mother is Rohini. He saw her the same in both Vrindavan and in Dwarka.
而 Balarama 的母亲 Rohini。他既在文达文，也在多尔卡城，所以他现在狗帕库马尔也看到了他。
The only feature in Krishna that was different in Dwarka was that Krishna had the sacred thread on in Dwarka. He never had that before.
Dwarka 的城的 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 唯一的区别就是，在 Dwarka 城的 Krishna 他佩戴着圣线，而在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 是没有圣线的。
So that Brahman thread that was given to him by Sandipani Muni when he got initiation, when he had gone there to the ashram of Sandipani Muni.
这根婆罗门圣线是主 Krishna 去 Sandipani Muni 的 Ashram，他得到启迪之后所佩戴在身上的。
Of course, Krishna would not. Krishna would conceal that thread because he would wear a cloth over the top of the thread.
当然，主 Krishna 总是隐藏着这根圣线。因为他总是身上穿着衣服。
So Krishna became it was feeling very compassionate, and he saw Gop Kumar faint, so he put his lotus hand on Gop Kumar and brought him back to consciousness.
Krishna 总是心存怜悯，当他看见 Gopa Kumar 昏过去的时候，他把他的手放在了 Gopa Kumar 身上，使他又恢复了知觉。
And then he cleansed all the limbs of the body of Gop Kumar for him. Because Gop Kumar had fainted, so he'd fallen on the ground. So the Lord not only picked him up, but he also dusted him, took the dust off his body.
因为 Gopa Kumar 昏倒在地上， 所以他身上沾上了尘土。这 Krishna 不仅把他从地上扶了起来，还轻轻地把他浑身上下的尘土都给掸落了。
So in Dwarka, Krishna is a powerful prince.
在多尔卡，主 Krishna 是一位强而有力的王子。
And in Vrindavan, he is the darling son of Nanda Maharaj and all the people of Vrindavan.
而在文达文，他是南达玛哈拉兹的爱儿，也是文达文所有居民的最宠爱的孩子。
And Lord Krishna is always concerned to keep the devotees of Vrindavan happy.
主 Krishna 总是确保 Vrindavan 的全体居民们都感到快乐。
So that's why he felt so much concern when he saw Gop Kumar faint. Then the Lord was very concerned about him.
因此，当主 Krishna 看到 Gopal Kumar 昏过去的时候，他便十分关切。
So the time had come for lunch, but Lord Krishna didn't feel like eating.
到了午餐的时间，可是主 Krishna 一点儿也不想吃饭。
And only because his mothers insisted, did he do his noontime duties.
可是他的母亲们坚持让他一定要履行中午的职责。
Lord Krishna had become disturbed, remembering his childhood, remembering Gokula and Vrindavan, so he had no more appetite. He was feeling instead the pain of separation.
主 Krishna 感到心意受到了打扰。他想起了在狗哭了文达文孩提时代的逍遥时光，所以他一点儿也没有胃口，他感受到了分离的痛苦。
But Devaki and all the Vasudev's other wives, they're all like a mother to Krishna, and they wouldn't let Krishna go without eating.
Devaki 和 Vasudeva 的其他的妻子们，她们都像 Krishna 的母亲那样，她们坚持 Krishna 一定要吃饭。
But first of all, he has to take his midday bath and do his other duties.
To Krishna 首先必须要履行他中午的职责，并且中午他要沐浴。
So that at that time, then the Lord Krishna fed something to Gop Kumar. He fed some prasadam to Gop Kumar.
To Krishna 给 Gopal Kumar，喂了一些 prasad 的食物。
So Lord Krishna agreed to eat because he wanted to please his mother.
主 Krishna 之所以进餐，只是为了取悦他的母亲们。
But he also wanted to eat because he wanted his friends to eat. They would only do it in Krishna's presence.
Krishna 之所以进餐的另一个原因是， 他希望他的朋友们也吃饭，因为他的朋友们只有当着的 Krishna 的面儿才会跟他一同进餐。
So Lord Krishna got his older brother Balaram to sit down with a circle of boys, and Krishna fed them.
这 Krishna 让他的哥哥 Balarama 和一群男孩子们围成一圈坐下来，他亲手给他们派饭。
Lord Krishna is sitting with the boys just as he did when he was in his childhood pastimes.
Krishna 就像他孩提时代的逍遥时光里那样，和一群男孩子们坐在一起。
Sometimes Lord Balaram would sit in the center of the circle, and all the boys, young boys, the young boys of the Yadu dynasty, they would all sit around him. Just like the whorl of the lotus when it's in bloom. So Lord Balaram would be the whorl in the center of the lotus.
有的时候，主巴拉拉玛会坐在中心，而那些男孩子们是围绕着他，团团的坐在他的四周，就好像一朵盛开的莲花，他莲花的中心，莲心，主巴拉拉玛就像莲花的莲心一样。
In the past, Krishna and Balaram would enjoy their midday meal like this in Vrindavan.
在过去以前，主 Krishna 和巴拉拉玛在稳大稳的时候就是这样，坐在中午的时间和他的小伙伴们一起，坐在以这种形状坐在一起共进午餐的。
And at that time, they would sit and talk together and they would laugh and enjoy each other's company.
那时候，他们在彼此的陪伴当中，会一起谈话，一起笑，欢声笑语不断。
So, Lord Krishna. In the form of sacrifice, he will eat the offerings of the yajna.
主 Krishna 在祭祀当中，他会接受所有祭祀的贡品。
But now, Lord Krishna was showing his childhood pastimes. And he sits with the flute tucked beside his waist.
而现在的主 Krishna 展示的是他孩提时代，逍遥时光的样子。他把笛子别在他的腰间。
He has his bugle horn on the other side, on the right side, and he has a stick for driving the cows on the left.
主 Krishna 的右手拿着一根水牛号角，而他的左手拿着一根驱赶母牛的棍子。
And he's holding in his hand the rice and yogurt with pieces of fruit between his fingers.
他的右侧的腰间别着一个水牛角，左侧的腰间别着一根赶母牛的棍子。现在啊，他的手里呢就拿着一团酸奶饭拌饭，而他的手指头之间呢还夹着那些食物的碎屑。
So Krishna sat in the center looking at all of his friends and joking with them and laughing with each other as they ate their lunch.
现在，这 Krishna 就坐在中央，他看着他的伙伴们，和他们开着玩笑，和他们一起放声大笑，然后他们一起就这样共进着午餐。
So the demigods in heaven were watching, and it was a shock to them to see how the personality of Godhead was eating with his friends in the forest. Because usually the only thing he would eat would be the yajna.
天上的半神人们都惊愕地看着人格神手在森林当中和他的朋友们这样吃饭，因为通常情况下，主他是在祭祀当中才会接受贡品。
So we see here how Krishna eats with his friends instead of serving the meal.
现在我们看到的是主 Krishna 和他的朋友们在一起进餐，而不是他，给他们，在派饭。
The reason is because on this day Lord Balaram was not present.
这个原因是因为这一天主 Balarama 不在。
Now, Uddhava knew the Lord's ecstasies. He was very familiar with the ecstasies of Lord Krishna.
Uddhava 对于 Krishna 的狂喜之情非常熟悉。
So he ate some of Krishna's Mahaprasad remnants, and then he took Gop Kumar to his own house.
He 吃了主 Krishna 的一些 Mahaprasadam 之后，一些鲫鱼之后，就把Gopal Kumar 带到自己的家。
Now Lord Krishna was thinking that Gop Kumar would not be very comfortable in a palace with so much opulence.
Jo Krishna 认为 Gopal Kumar 处在富丽堂皇的宫殿四周。你都是那些富裕，然后可能不会感，会感到有些不自在。
So Gop Kumar decided, oh, Lord Krishna decided it would be better for Gop Kumar to go and stay with Uddhava's house, because Uddhava had a very special relationship with the people of Vrindavan.
于是，主 Krishna 便决定。Gopal Kumar 应该待在 Uddhava 的家中，因为 Uddhava 和 Vrindavan 有着特殊的关系。
Uddhava knew what Krishna was thinking without Krishna having to say anything.
即便 Krishna 不开口讲话，Uddhava 也了解 Krishna 的心思。
So when after Uddhava took some of Krishna's remnants from his prasad, then Uddhava got Gop Kumar to go with him. And they left without a word.
乌德瓦吃了主 Krishna 的普沙的那些剩余的鲫鱼之后，便和 Gopal Kumar 一起，一言不发的就离开了那个地方。
And Gop Kumar was still in a daze because all the wonderful things which had happened to him. So Uddhava had to drag him. Uddhava had to take him by the hand and bring him to the. Uddhava had to go and bring him.
因为这一
They
天
took
发
him
生，
by the hand.
由于这一整天发生的这些奇妙的事情，都令 Gopal Kumar 头晕目眩，所以 Uddhava 不得不拉着 Gopal Kumar 的手，把他拽着他离开了宫殿。
So it was only then that Gop Kumar came back to normal consciousness.
只是在这个时刻，戈帕库马尔才恢复了清醒。
Because they've taken Gop Kumar to Uddhava's house, so it was a more normal situation, and Gop Kumar was able to come back to his normal consciousness.
因为戈帕库马尔被带到了乌德瓦的房子，而在乌德瓦的房子当中是一种正常的状态，因此戈帕库马尔现在也恢复了常态。
And when Gop Kumar thought on all the things which had happened, then he began to dance, and he danced for a long time.
当戈帕库马尔回忆起这一天发生的事情的时候，他不禁跳起舞来，他跳了很长一段时间。
So Gop Kumar was happy to be with Krishna and his devotees there in Dwarka.
戈帕库马尔就这样非常快乐的在杜尔卡城和主 Krishna 待在一起。
And Gop Kumar thought to himself, he thought, today I have achieved the perfection of all my desire.
Gopal Kumar 不禁暗暗思忖道：“今天我所有长久以来的夙愿，终于达到了完美。”
Gop Kumar thought, with my very eyes I have seen the Lord, I've seen the attractive features of the hero of Vrindavan.
我亲眼目睹到文达文的英雄那充满魅力的特征。
So this Gop Kumar could understand that this was a form of the absolute truth, and that was Gop Kumar's meditation, the object of his meditation.
戈帕库马尔能够明白到，这就是绝对真理的形象，也是他冥想的对象。
And Lord Krishna is the enjoyer of Vrindavan, and he attracts the devotees in many ways.
主 Krishna 是 Vrindavan 的享乐者，他以各种各样的方式吸引着奉献者。
So the next day, Gopkumar went with Uddhava and they went to see the Lord.
第二天，格帕库马尔随同乌德瓦一起去见主。
But Gopkumar was still in so much ecstasy that he was not able to do any service other than just only he could see Krishna.
而格帕库马尔现在仍然处在狂喜的心绪当中。所以，除了去看，主 Krishna 之外，他什么服务也做不了。
And Gopkumar said when he stayed in Dwarka, he was constantly getting Krishna's wonderful mercy.
Gopakumar 说，当他在多尔卡城的时候，他恒常的得到了主 Krishna 奇妙的仁慈。
He said he tasted the ecstasy that no one could tell of it in words.
用他的话来说，他品味到的是言语无法表达的狂喜。
And he said, I couldn't even think of it in my mind.
他说：“我甚至都不能用心意去想这件事儿。”
So we have to understand that the glories of Krishna in Dwarka are beyond the understanding of even great scholars and mystic yogis.
我们要明白，在杜尔卡城的主 Krishna 的荣耀远远超越了任何伟大的学者和玄秘瑜伽师的理解范畴。
And it's very rare that even a surrendered devotee can understand these glories with the mind or words.
甚至连那些已经臣服了的奉献者们，也无法以他们的心意和言语去明白主 Krishna 的荣耀。这是他们也非常罕见能够理解这份荣耀。
The happiness that you get in liberation is supposed to be supreme.
一个人，从解脱当中所获得的快乐，
But
被认为是至高无上的。
you'd have to multiply it millions of times to equal the happiness of Vaikuntha.
而解脱得来的快乐，乘上100万倍，才可以和白坤特的快乐相媲美。
And there, of course, there's greater joys that something greater than Vaikuntha is to go to Ayodhya. And there's even greater joy, greater happiness in Ayodhya.
而在外，啊，Ayodhya 的喜乐，比 Vaikuntha 的喜乐更伟大。
But the joy in Dwarka is even greater that we cannot even begin to describe the happiness in Dwarka.
而多尔卡的喜乐要比阿尤爹的喜乐，更加伟大。我们甚至都无法开始形容这份喜乐。
So, for the impersonalists, they think the goal of life, the greatest happiness, the greatest pleasure, is to get out of the material existence.
对于非人格主义者，他们的目的是，得到就是摆脱物质的存在，从摆脱物质的存在当中获得巨大的快乐。
So these impersonalists, they don't understand that beyond the Brahmajyoti, there's a transcendental world where the happiness is much greater.
这些非人格主义者不明白，在梵光之上有一个超然的世界，在这个超然的世界当中存在着巨大的快乐。
The Vaishnavas, they will preach about these things, but not everyone likes to hear.
Vaishnava 们会向人们传播这些理念。但是有的人不喜欢听。
And among the Vaishnavas, they will describe that there's greater happiness found in the kingdom of Lord Ramachandra, which is Ayodhya.
而在 Vaishnava 当中呢，他们会讨论说，在主 Ramachandra 的王国 Ayodhya 存在着巨大的喜乐。
So just by logic, we can understand the happiness relished by Krishna and his devotees in Dwarka.
所以，通过逻辑，我们也可以去推理，在多尔卡城，主 Krishna 必定和他的同游们享受着巨大的喜乐。
Some people have studied the Vedas and they think about the happiness of liberation.
有些人一心一意的在研究伟达经，他们，可以从伟达经当中窥见解脱带来的快乐。
But more intelligent people, they will understand that the happiness of liberation is only the absence of material misery.
智者们会明白。解脱所带来的快乐，也只不过是因为没有物质痛苦而已。
And they will understand there must be some greater happiness, greater than the impersonal liberation. And that greater happiness, of course, is Vaikuntha.
他们明白。在非人格的解脱之上，一定存在着更巨大的快乐，而这份更巨大的喜乐之情，可以在瓦昆塔可以找到。
But if in the spiritual world, there is also Ayodhya, where the Lord's servants have such great devotion for Lord Rama.
而在灵性世界，还存在着阿尤迪亚，在那里，主的仆人们怀着巨大的奉爱之情服务着主。
And even better happiness than Vaikuntha is in Dwarka.
而在白昆塔的多尔塔，可以找到更巨大的喜乐。
And this is not just a devotee sentiment, but reliable authorities. They've seen it, they've gone there for themselves and seen it all.
这并不是奉献者们一厢情愿的感情用事而已，而是可信的权威们，他们亲自去了那里，并且亲眼目睹了这一切。
So the pleasure which the people of Dwarka get from their relationship with Lord Krishna is beyond the power of our mind or speech to express.
在多尔塔居民们以 Krishna 的关系，从与 Krishna 关系当中获得的喜乐之情，是用心意和言语无法表达的。
Only those people whose minds are fit can understand it. You have to be qualified to understand the happiness.
要明白这份喜乐，一个人必须有资格，他的心意一定是非常的稳，心坚意稳的。
So people, there may be some people with very strong intelligence, but they have weak faith in devotion to Krishna.
有一些人拥有强大的智性，但是他们在对 Krishna 的奉爱当中，他们的信心非常薄弱。
So they may doubt if there's any happiness greater than what's in Ayodhya.
他们甚至会怀疑，在Ayodhya 是否存在着更巨大的喜乐。
So these people, they don't know the happiness of Dwarka.
这些人对多尔卡城的喜乐更是一无所知。
So they have no right to say that it doesn't exist. They cannot say it doesn't exist. They don't know.
因为他们一无所知，所以他们也没有权利否定在多尔卡城的喜乐的存在。
But there are other people who are more qualified and they know the taste of Dwarka.
还有另外一些人，他们更有资格，所以他们有权利。他们对多尔卡城的情况，他们是有权利来说的。
Even though our words and our mind cannot understand the bliss of Dwarka, but it's been described by others.
我们的话语，我们的心意是无法去理解多尔卡的其乐之情的，因为它超越了言语和心意的描述。
It is described for the benefit of the devotees to encourage their enthusiasm for devotional service.
这一切之所以得以描述，目的是为了鼓励奉献者们热情地去从事奉献服务。
And just as the devotees of Ayodhya get great happiness in their intimate mood of service. The devotees of Dwarka enjoy happiness greater because they're personally connected to Krishna in the mood of friendship.
就像在Ayodhya 的奉献者们体验到了巨大的喜乐之情，同样，在 Dwarka 的奉献者们处在与 Krishna 的友情当中，他们也同样体会到了巨大的快乐。
And if we think a bit further, we can understand that the happiness of Goloka is far beyond all that.
如果我们再这样进一步的去思考的话，就会得出结论，在 Goloka 的喜乐之情一定更加巨大。
So after Gop Kumar had lived in Dwarka for some time, some of the Yadavas said to him,
Gopa 库
they said
尔，
this, they spoke to Gop Kumar.
当 Gopa 库尔在朵尔卡城居住了一段时间之后，有一些亚杜族人就对他这样说。
They wanted to see everyone in the world happy. They want to see them happy within and without.
他们希望看到世人，内心和外在都快乐。
So Gop Kumar, he had lived in Dwarka and he had experience of the happiness there.
现在，Gopa Kumar 居住在朵尔卡，他便体验到了在朵尔卡的快乐。
So while he was staying there, he was approached by some of the residents of Dwarka who wanted everyone to experience the greatest happiness.
因为他在朵尔卡停留了，居住了一段时间，所以，在那里的居民，在那里的亚达巴们，他们希望人人都能体验到朵尔卡给人们带来的快乐。
So the Yadavas said to Gop Kumar, they said, "You've come to this place, Dwarka, which is full of spiritual opulence, more than Vaikuntha, and now you are our companion."
他们对 Gopa Kumar 说：“现在你已经来到了这个富裕的朵尔卡，而朵尔卡比外昆塔的，比外昆塔的富裕更加伟大。”
So they said to Gop Kumar, "We think it will be fitting. We think it's not fitting for you to keep dressing like you're a forest dweller, like you live in the forest, which you were doing when you were a cowherd boy."
他们说：“我们认为，你继续穿着这身，就牧牛童的，在森林当中居住，森林的居民，那些牧牛童的这袭装束，是在这个朵尔卡这里就不适合了。”
So these people of Dwarka, they felt that Gop Kumar's dress was not fitting for Dwarka.
那这些亚杜族人呢，认为 Gopa Kumar 的这一身装束就不适合这里的情况。
So they said to Gop Kumar, "This is troubling our mind. So please, can you put on our type of dress and look like us.
他们说道：“你这一身装束呢，就令我们的心意受到了干扰，所以你能否请你穿上我们像我们这一类的服装，然后看上去就像我们一样呢？”
So the people, these people of Dwarka, they were experiencing the highest ecstasy living in Dwarka with the Lord, but they felt a little unhappy to see Gop Kumar dressed in his old clothes, which was when he was a forest, when he was staying in the forest.
这些人因为在杜尔卡城和主在一起，所以体验到了巨大的狂喜。但是，当他们看到勾帕库马仍旧穿着他在森林里待着的时候所穿的那一袭旧衣服的时候，他们就感到有点不快乐。
So Gop Kumar didn't have to wonder, he didn't have to think about where to get the right dress so that he could look like a Dwarkavasi. But the very atmosphere of Dwarka provides all the residents with everything they want.
库帕库马尔不用去思考，他从哪里能得到这一身正确的衣服，看上去就像杜尔卡的居民们一样，因为杜尔卡城的氛围本身就可以提供人们，就可以提供人们，在居住在那里所应该穿的正确的衣服。
But Gop Kumar said, even though the Yadavas insisted, he said, I stayed in my same dress. I remained staying like looking like a poor, simple devotee.
杜帕库马尔说：“哪怕这些雅杜族人坚持己见，我仍然继续穿着那一身旧衣服，看上去就像一个贫穷的、可怜的、简单的奉献者。”
Gop Kumar said if he had changed his dress, he wouldn't be able to enjoy that special mood which appeals to his mind and to Lord Krishna.
格帕库马尔说：“如果他改变自己的衣装的话，他就不能享受那份令吸引他的心意，并且吸引到主 Krishna 的那种心态了。”
Gop Kumar preferred to stay inferior to these Yadavas.
格帕库马尔宁愿让自己的地位低于这些雅杜族人。
Yeah, he considered what more important than having a nice appearance. He thought it's more important to protect his personal relationship with Krishna.
他认为，与其让他外貌看上去更精致更美观，他宁愿比那更重要的是保持着他跟 Krishna 之间的个人的关系。
So Gop Kumar said, after that, I became shy and I was afraid to go to the side to go and be near Krishna when he was seated in his court and when he was being served by all opulence.
格帕库马尔就说：“在这 在这之后呢，我就感到非常的难为情，我就害怕，不敢接近，坐在议事大厅的主 Krishna，有所种种的赋予所服侍着主 Krishna。
Yeah, Gopkumar wanted to keep his inner consciousness. He wanted to keep his mood of service to Krishna. So he didn't want to change his dress.
他库马尔就想要保持自己的内在知觉，继续保持他服务 Krishna 的心态，因此他不想改变自己的服饰。
But this caused that it disturbed his heart. So, because they brought this to his attention, he felt uncomfortable about appearing before Krishna.
但是，这件事就打扰了他的心意，他便很谨慎的，也警觉起来。因此呢，他在主 Krishna 面前之后，他就感觉到有点不自在了，不像之前那么自在。
Yeah, he thought his own appearance was not fitting and was not appreciated by others. And he thought he might do something wrong.
因为他认为他的这一身装束外貌不适合那个氛围，他不被人们所欣赏，啊，可能做错了什么事。
He was embarrassed, and he was also quite disturbed by all the great opulence which was there in Dwarka, especially in the Sudharma Hall, and the big crowds of kings and sages and demigods.
东帕库马尔，他就有点儿，感觉到有点窘迫。而且除此之外，他也被杜尔卡城的富丽堂皇所打扰，尤其是在苏达玛大议事大厅，那里有成群结队的国王、圣人们和半神人们。
So, because he felt uncomfortable about coming near Krishna, Gopkumar began thinking about going somewhere else.
因为他现在在 Krishna 面前已经有点不自在了，于是他的心意就想去别的地方。
He says sometimes he would see the Lord with four hands.
他说，有时候他会看到主有着四个臂膀。
But he couldn't see the special pastimes which the Lord performs in Vrindavan.
他再看不到主 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 所上演的逍遥时光了。
And when devotees like Rukmini were present, then Gopkumar couldn't think of Krishna in Vrindavan pastimes.
当像 Rukmini 这样的奉献者在那里的时候，哥帕库马尔也联想不到文大文的逍遥时光。
And when Krishna was talking with Narada Muni or Arjuna, then Gopkumar couldn't think of him taking care of his cow.
当主 Krishna 和拿勒穆尼以及和阿朱娜交谈的时候，哥帕库马尔也联想不到 Krishna 照料母牛的情景。
Gopkumar would sometimes see Krishna as if in Vrindavan, but not very often.
有的时候， Gopa Kumar 会看到 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的情景，但并不是那么经常出现。
And sometimes Krishna would go to visit his friends, the Pandavas. They lived nearby, but Krishna would go alone.
有的时候，Krishna 会拜访居住在附近的潘多瓦五兄弟，但是 Krishna 是一个人去。
Just like on Earth, the Pandavas lived quite a distance away from Dwarka. At that time, they lived in Hastinapur. So Krishna had to make a long journey to meet them.
在地球上，潘多瓦们居住的地方，他们居住的哈斯提纳普尔离多尔卡城有相当遥远的距离，所以主奎师呢必须得长途跋涉去见潘多瓦们。
But in Vaikuntha, it's a different situation.
而到了白昆塔是另外一种情况。
Even if the home of the Pandavas is a long way from Dwarka, in the spiritual realm, there's no limitation of time and space.
哪怕是潘达瓦们的家离多尔卡城，很远，距离很远，但是在灵性的领域，那里没有时间和空间的局限性。
Just by the power of Krishna's desire, any place he wants to travel is at once nearby.
仅仅是凭借着 Krishna 的愿望的力量。无论他想旅行到哪里，那个地方就会立刻出现在附近。
So Gokumar had these desires in his heart, so he would feel trouble.
现在，Gopal Kumar 有了另一个心愿，所以他就感到有点心神不安。
But whenever he would see the beauty of Lord Krishna and the wonderful qualities, then he would again become peaceful.
可是他一旦见到主 Krishna 的俊美和他的美奇妙的品质，他心意又再度平和下来。
If he couldn't see Krishna for a little while, then he would become disturbed. But whenever Krishna would return, then Gop Kumar would recover and he'd feel better.
哪怕是他一时半会儿见不到 Krishna。他也会感到心神不安，而 Krishna 一旦又回来之后，Gopa Kumar 又会恢复心态，他会感觉良好了。
Just the words of Krishna showed his mercy.
仅仅是 Krishna 的话语，Krishna 透过他的话语便展示了他的仁慈。
So, in this way, Gopkumar spent several days in the home of Uddhava, and if there were any unhappiness, he said he would cover it. He would pretend to be happy.
就这样，哥帕库马尔在乌德瓦的房子当中居住了几天。即便他感到不快乐，他也会掩饰自己的情绪，假装快乐的样子。
So when Krishna would be away from Dwarka, it would cause some anxiety for Gopkumar.
一旦 Krishna 离开了多尔卡，恐怕库马尔就会感到内心的焦虑。
And another anxiety would be when he would remember about the place of his birth.
而他焦虑的另外一个原因是，当他想起他的出生地。
So when Gop Kumar couldn't see Krishna in Vrindavan performing his pastimes in Vrindavan, he would feel unhappy, but he would try to cover it from the people in Dwarka.
多帕库马尔，他看不见 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 上演的消失光，就会感到不快乐。但是在 Dwarka 的居民面前，他会努力掩饰自己的情绪。
The people in Dwarka couldn't tolerate to see anyone in pain.
Dwarka 的居民们无法忍受看到任何人处在痛苦的情绪中。
So one day Narada Muni came and Gop Kumar bowed down to him. And in joy and amazement, he spoke to him.
那个天，哪儿的目的就来了。格巴库马尔向他致以顶拜，他以一种说，他以 in a
So
他
Narada
便。
Muni's come at just at the right time to tell Gop Kumar about the glories of Goloka and to tell him how he can go to Goloka.
Narada Muni 出现的时间恰逢其时，他正好就可以告诉 Gopa Kumar 有关于 Goloka 的荣耀。
Okay, we'll stop here.
那我们今天的正课就讲到这里，现在我们看一下问题。我们先来回答一下这边的问题。Mark, there is a devotee. He want to say something to you about giving a class for Srimad Bhagavatam for Yesentuki. At 1 p.m. Chinese time. This is from Kirtida. David, I
Yeah,
see.
but I'm traveling today. I can't do it today.
OK. 马儿说，因为他在旅行，所以他今天讲不了课。那我们看到这个问题是，第一个问题是攀着他的吧。巴布说，顶拜马儿拉指，格巴库马尔与乌德瓦是什么关系？So, what is the relationship between Gopa Kumar and Uddhava?
Well, they're both devotees of Krishna. Uddhava is one of Krishna's principal advisors, and he's a relative of Lord Krishna. Uddhava resides in Dwarka. He also resides sometimes in Vrindavan and also in Badari's ashram, but mainly here in Brihadbhagavatamrita is a resident of Dwarka. Now Gop Kumara, he's from the Govardhan Hill. He's a cowherd boy.
他们两个人都是 Krishna 的朋友，Uddhava 是主 Krishna 的主要的顾问，也是主 Krishna 的亲戚。Uddhava 他既住在 Dwarka，他也在 Vrindavan，也在 Badrika Ashram。而在《大伯加瓦堂甘露》这本书当中，Uddhava 的身份是主要是 Dwarka 的居民。而 Gopa Kumar 是来自于 Govardhan 山的一位牧牛童。
So Uddhava is a very educated, learned person. He is a disciple of Brihaspati.
Uddhava 是非常有 教育受过教养的，有博学的，博学的学者，博学
And
的人，他是 Brihas Bharati 的门生。
Gop Kumar doesn't have that kind of education.
而高巴库马尔却没有受过这样的教育。
So there's a big difference between the two.
所以这两个人还是有着相当大的区别的。
But they're both great devotees.
但他们两个人都是伟大的奉献者。
Yeah.
下一个问题是这位来自，这位。
啊？
一个 KB，因为他说 Udava 见到了4B 的 Krishna，不是 Udava 见到，是 Gopa Kumar。
Yeah.
下一个问题是老郑发布的问题，感谢马老师翻译和主持。第一个问题是 Gopa Kumar 周游四方，目的何在？是为了寻找爱吗？Gopa Kumar traveled everywhere. What is the goal? Is it to search for love?
No, he's searching out for the Supreme Lord.
不是为了寻找爱，而是为了寻找至尊主。
He wants to find the highest perfection in the dealings with the Lord.
他希望在和主的交流当中寻找到最高的完美境界。
He wants to know where can he get that greatest. The greatest loving relationship.
他想要寻找到在哪里能够获得这份最伟大的爱的交流。下一个问题，第二部分，经典中说这个世界没有真爱，令不少人震惊、失落、心碎。有人提出异议，这个世界还是有爱的，只是不纯粹，混杂的爱。请问，混杂的爱是不是一种爱？与 Krishna 无关的爱是不是爱？真爱的定义到底是什么？In the scripture, it is said there is no real love in this world. Though many people feel shocked and lost and heartbroken because of this statement, and someone argued that in this world there is love, but it is not pure love, it is mixed love. So may I ask, even the mixed love, is it also a kind of love? And the love that is unrelated to Krishna, is it also a love? And what is the definition of genuine love?
Well, genuine love is to love Krishna because love of Krishna means you love every living entity and you love everything because we see everything as Krishna and Krishna's energy. Krishna's energy, every living entity is a part of Krishna, and we see that everyone in relation to Krishna.
真爱是去爱 Krishna，因为 Krishna 他和每个生物都有关系，每个生物都属于 Krishna，而且一切万事万物都跟 Krishna 有关系，每个生物都是 Krishna 的所属部分，而且一切都是 Krishna 的能量。我们爱了 Krishna，就会爱所有的众生。
In the material world, yes, we say there's no real love, but what we call love is more lust, because the so-called love which we claim to others, is very limited and it's selfish also. It's love given with expectation of something in return.
在这个世界上没有真爱，那些所谓的爱只是色欲。我们放在别的生物身上的所谓的爱都是有限的和自私的。我们给予这份爱是有所期待的，我们期待着得到回报。
Loving, so-called loving relationships are all business relationships. We want something in return.
所谓的爱的关系，只不过是一种生意的关系，因为我们都期待着得到回报。
Just like we talk about cheating religion.
我们会说有存在着一种欺骗的宗教。
Right? Cheating religion is people come to God and they say to God, I love you, I love you. But they're thinking, where's the money?
欺骗的宗教就是人们来到上帝面前，口口声声的说上帝，我很爱你，但实际上他们心里在想着钱在哪儿，钱从哪里能得到钱财。
Are they thinking, solve my problems? I'm love you, so I'm giving you love, so you should solve all my problems, take away my troubles.
他们也会这样跟上帝进行交换。上帝，我给你爱，你要把我的问题解决了，你要拿走我的麻烦。
Okay.
OK。好，那我们看，如果没有回答，您继续问。下一个问题是，卡路尼亚说。杜尔卡也不是戈帕库尔的最终目的地。Ananta Rupa Devadase 说：“顶拜固若奉献者。”我们不穿天然皮革的衣服，但为什么穿丝绸衣服？因为加工丝绸的时候要杀死那些蚕。我们能穿天然丝绸做的衣服吗？We don't wear clothes made by the skin of the animal, but why we wear silk clothes? Because the worms all are killed before we get the silk. So can we wear those natural the clothes made by natural silk?
Yes, you can get ahimsa silk.
You 可以去得到那些非暴力的丝绸。
And if you, there's a special silk which is worn by some people. It's called ahimsa silk. They wait till the silkworm dies and then they take the cocoon.
有一种丝绸被叫做非暴力丝绸。就是，人们会等到这些蚕，这些蚕，天然的、自然的死去之后，再得到这些茧、丝绸。
But you can also get cotton. You can get cloth, which is called khadi. Khadi is a nice cotton. There's no synthetic, there's no chemicals, and it's made by handloom. It's also very nice to wear. Khadi. In India, they have a shop called Khadi Bhavan, the Khadi Bhavan, and they sell all the cloth, all the cloth in the shop is made from khadi, which means it's a cotton.
诶，卡迪，So sorry,
Khadi,
Mara.
yeah, K-H-A-D-I. It's just a name. It's a type of cotton.
Oh, okay. It's a cotton, not silk, it's cotton.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. 就是在印度呢，他们有这种叫卡迪布，是棉布，他们是用棉花制成的，所以他们卖的都是这种卡迪，用卡迪棉制成的布，这种天然的，没有任何化学添加剂，也没有任何的这种化纤，是都是纯棉，所以叫卡迪布。
But you can also get the Ahimsa silk if you want. It's white, all white color. Ahimsa.
你也可以去找一找有没有这种非暴力的丝绸，这种丝绸呢，它是纯白色的，没有染过色的。
Okay.
OK，thank you。下一个问题，天娱婷婷雅竹说：“顶白孤儿奉献者这本书什么时候能出中文版的书呢？”就是 She's asking。When can we get the Chinese version of Brihad Bhagavatamrita?
Oh, I don't know. You have to ask Astradacharan Prabhu.
不知道，那这件事儿得问，询问拉确认他不。
He's in charge of BBT.
他是 BBT 的负责人。下一个问题是 Vaikuntha Voice，顶白 Guru Maharaj，有人认为物质世界孩子在很小的时候对父母的爱是真爱，是这样吗？Someone regard the love when the small child。Their love for their parents is true love. Is it right?
Well, it's a form of love, but it's very limited love. Often the parents they love, of course, they love their child. Well, the child loves the parents because they're dependent. The child is dependent on the parents for care and protection. And the parents, they love the child because the parents are thinking, my child. They're thinking, this is my child. Actually, the child has taken birth many times, but the parents are thinking, this is my child. So there's a strong bodily connection there, which is material. It's not spiritual.
您所说的这种爱呢，是一种，也是一种形式的爱，但是非常有限的爱。在物质世界，父母爱孩子的时候呢，会想着这是我的孩子。实际上，他们的孩子已经出生了很多次了，但他们就依然认为这是我的孩子，所以这是出于一种强烈的躯体化的关系。所以这是物质的，不是灵性的。而孩子们，他们爱自己的父母呢，主要是他们依赖于自己的父母去照顾他们，保护他们。
啊。
下一个问题是。来自于 Chaitanya Mangala Devi Dasi，顶拜 Guru Day 翻译和奉献者。我的问题是，Gopa Kumar 为什么不直接回文答案呢？是主的安排吗？ 谢谢 Good day. Why Gopal Kumar didn't go back to Vrindavan directly? Is it the arrangement of Lord Krishna?
Yes.
Sh
It's the
Shida.
arrangement of Lord Krishna to let him see all the other places for our benefit, because we have to know about these other places. In that way, then we can understand more the very special position of Vrindavan.
是的，主 Krishna 就安排 Gopal Kumar 去目睹，别的地方，也都是为了我们的好处。这样呢，我们就可以知道有这种种的地点的存在，也能够明白温达文是一个特殊的地方。下一个问题是 Nanda Padmini Devadasi 顶拜 Kumara 之。那正在讲课问题，物质世界的爱是不真实的话，那奉献者对至尊主的服务和祈祷会怎么样？只是单纯的向上输出的精神能量吗？如果您愿意的话，请解惑。If in the material world there's no genuine love, then what about devotee service and prayer to the Supreme Lord? Is it simple? Is it only a kind of spiritual energy that we transfer upwards?
Well, I said there's no love in the material world, means in material relationships. But if one is praying to Krishna, that can be real love. If one may be in this world, and if he's offering praying, sincere prayers to Krishna, then that is real love.
刚才马尔说的是物质世界的关系，而在这个世界上，倘若某人向 Krishna 供奉着真诚的祈祷，那他的这个是真实的爱。那下个问题。By Quinta Voice，奉献者之间的关系是爱还是充满了期待呢？What about the relationship between devotees? Is it genuine love or is it also full of expectation?
Well, that depends on the devotee.
Mm-hmm. 您说的这种情况是取决于是什么样的奉献者？
When you do something for the devotee, are you doing it for their Krishna consciousness and for your own Krishna consciousness? Are you doing it for some material benefit? It depends on your attitude. Are you performing the activity in relation with the devotee for some benefit, material, or for your spiritual benefit?
嗯，这取决于个人的心态。你为奉献者做事情是为了物质的好处呢，还是为了自己的 Krishna 之觉的利益呢？
Now, in the Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami describes loving relationships between one devotee and another.
你是再补充一下，刚才。说到奉献者，为奉献者做事情，你是为了物质的好，自己的物质好处，还是自己的 Krishna 之觉，还是为了这个奉献者的 Krishna 之觉？在 Rupa Goswami 的教诲的甘露谈到了奉献之间的几种的爱心的交流。
Rupa Goswami said offering gifts in charity and accepting charitable gifts, offering prasadam and accepting prasadam, and inquiring confidentially and revealing your mind and confidence are the six kinds of loving exchanges between one devotee and another.
给奉献者礼物，不失礼物，接受奉献者的礼物，给予奉献者 prasada 接受奉献者的 prasada 机密的询问，向奉献者提出机密的询问，以及向奉献者袒露心声，这是奉献之间的六种的爱心的交流。
So the relationships vary. What is your attitude? Are you doing it in Krishna consciousness? Are you doing it with a genuine feeling of love? Or are you just doing it for some benefit? You want to be recognized as a great devotee, or do you expect to get something in return for what we're doing?
所以，这是取决于，奉献者的心态，他们是不是在 Krishna 知觉当中做事儿，还是他们并没有真爱的去交流，还是为了某种物质，为了某种好处去交流？如果，或者是某人，他想被人们公认为是伟大的奉献者，或者是他期待着得到一些回报。
Okay.
OK，下一个问题是来自于 Baba Tarini Devi Dasi，顶拜 Guru Dev 奉献者，我昨晚做了个梦，梦中一盆 Tulsi 说话了，说把它送到另一户人家。养这盆 Tulsi 的奉献者就问，谁想要这盆 Tulsi？我说我要，然后那位奉献者说。那你就要天天给 Tusi 做 RT，Guru，我现在在养 Tusi，但是没有给他做 RT，是不是 Tusi 提醒我要给他做 RT 呢？感恩您。So Baba Tanarini Dev Das is saying that Guru Dev, yesterday I had a dream. In the dream, one Tusi spoke, began to speak, and she said, please send me to another house. 2 And the devotee What, and the devotee who take care of the Tulsi asked who want this Tulsi, and I said that I want. And then the devotee said that you have to do the arti to Tulsi every day. So Guru, may I ask that because right now I'm also taking care of Tulsi, but I'm not doing arti for her. So is it that in a dream that Tulsi is remind me that I should perform arti for her?
Yes, you should. It's not doesn't take very long to perform Tulsi Arti. I encourage you to do it every day.
要做这个 Tusi Arti，不要花费很长时间，所以 Guru 说鼓励你每天都给他做 Tusi Arti。
Chant the Tulsi Arti song, circumambulate Tulsi, and offer your obeisances.
每天给唱那个 Tusi 的祷文，然后呢绕拜 Tusi。 向 Tusi 顶拜。
Okay.
难道 Patni 刚才回答您的问题了？就是您问的问题，说的这个问题，就刚才回答了，有关于物质世界的爱，是，就是奉献者对至尊主祈祷这个问题。不然的话，您再打一遍。下一个问题是 Prema Nandini 顶拜 Guru 奉献者，如何克服喝咖啡的习惯？我有低血压，除了咖啡没什么帮助。So I have the my blood pressure is pretty low, therefore I have the habit to drink coffee. So how can I overcome this habit?
Well, you can drink something else, drink some ginger tea, or you can get some decaffeinated coffee. But the problem is caffeine is there in coffee, and it's not offerable to Krishna. So you want some hot drink, you like to drink something hot, so make some ginger tea or some herbal tea.
那你可以喝生姜茶呀，或者喝那些已经去掉了咖啡因的咖啡茶，咖啡就是没有，因为问题就在于咖啡里头有咖啡因，而咖啡因是不能供奉给主 Krishna 的。倘若您想要喝一些热饮的话，您可以制作，生姜茶，或者自己制作一些花茶。
Okay.
OK，难得 partner，但奉献者也还是在三维的认知中做服务，我们怎么区分呢？三维的认知，but devotee is also doing the service in the consciousness of three dimensional consciousness. How to distinguish these devotees?
为了什么？为了什么？Three-dimensional consciousness, the bodily consciousness.
您说的这个三维空认知呢，还是躯体化的知觉？就那您说的三维的认知是什么意思呢？下一个问题是，您再澄清一下。下一个问题是，Prema Lalita Devadasi Dinpai Guru Dev，您说奉献者相互赠送礼物，如果有奉献者为了达到某些目的送礼物，我们怎么办呢？怎么去分辨？就是我们现在的躯体化的认知。Yeah, she is saying that if devotee are doing the service in the bodily consciousness,
Yes, maybe they're doing it in the bodily, but they're doing service, so they should be encouraged to come to a higher consciousness. We should help them to think of Krishna. We should chant the holy name, and we should tell them about Krishna.
也许奉献者有奉献者是确实是在躯体化的概念当中，但是因为他们在从事着服务，所以我们要鼓励他们去达到更高的知觉，要帮助他们去想着 Krishna，鼓励他们去唱诵圣名，告诉他们有关 Krishna 的事情。
Yeah, we should appreciate, we should be appreciative that they want to do service, even though they may have some material motive, but they have the mood to do some service. So that's good. They should be encouraged. And by hearing and by association, they will come to a higher consciousness.
我们应该欣赏奉献者的服务，哪怕是他们怀着物质的动机在从事着服务，那因为他们在从事着服务，所以这本身就是一个很好的行为，所以我们要鼓励他们，我们要鼓励他们去聆听，鼓励他们继续服务，好让他们去达到一个更高的知觉状态。Prima Lalita is asking, you said devotees are giving gift and accepting gift, but if some devotee are sending out a gift for some purpose, so what should we do?
Some devotees are what?
Giving the gift to others.
Yeah.
But they have some motive. She's asking, so what should we do with the gift and how to distinguish?
Well, we should accept the gift and use it for Krishna's service, right? Somebody gives us a gift, we accept it and use it for Krishna. They may have some material motive to get something from Krishna. That's their problem. But the gift, we should take it and use it for Krishna.
所以，我们应该接受这份礼物，然后呢，把它们用来服务 Krishna。有人呢，哪怕是他怀着一些动机给予了这个礼物，但这是他们的问题。而对于我们这一方来说，我们应该接受这份礼物，然后把它用作 Krishna 给予 Krishna 做服务。
Okay.
OK。您说的这个京东淘宝有无咖啡因啊？Some devotee, Nimai Nitai Dasis said that in the 淘宝京东 there is coffee that is without caffeine。
Okay, so you can use that.
那你就可以去买
If
这个。
there's no caffeine.
那你就可以买这个，不含咖啡因的咖啡。Nanda Patan Devadasi。奉献者做服务也真诚，但由于有这个躯体，所以有生老病死。有几个人摆脱了呢？怎么理解？没有物质做支撑的服务，地球人靠冥想做服务更恰当吗？干枯的仁慈。So even if devotees are doing the service and with sincerity, but because the body is there, still there's birth, old age, disease and death. So she's asking how many people have really get rid of those birth, death, disease and old age, and how to understand it. And as far as the service is concerned, if the service is not supported by material possessions. So maybe it's better to do service by meditating. So she wants to confirm this.
Well, how many people are liberated. There's many more living entities in the spiritual world than there are in the material world. In the material world, we're minority. There's many more living entities living in the spiritual world.
有关于您说的第一部分问题，那么在灵性世界比在物质世界的生物体要多得多得多，而我们在物质世界的生物体只是少数少数，很少数，而在灵性世界的生物要比物质世界的生物要多多很多。
Just like in the material world, some people are in prison, they're in the jail, they're criminals, but they're the minority. Most people are law-abiding citizens and they live a normal life. But those people who are criminals, they're in the prison house. So in the same way, we are the sinful people, we're the criminals, we're here in the material world. But the vast majority of people are liberated souls in the spiritual world.
这个物质世界就是一座监狱，那么这个罪犯呢，只是少数的人，而那些遵纪守法的市民呢，他们是大多数人，他们过着正常的生活。我们在这个物质世界呢，我们都是罪犯，而大多数人解脱了的人呢，解脱了的生物体，他们是居住在灵性世界的。
What were the other questions which she had?
The other, the, she said, the service that is not supported by material. There's no, if the our service is not supported, there is no material support for our service. Then it's better to only meditate, to do service for the people on the earth.
No, of course, meditation, thinking to do good is also nice, but it's better that if you can actually do it, not just think about doing it. Of course, it's good that you think about doing it, doing good for others, that's very good, but it's better if you can actually do it and get up and go and do something for the other people, not just think about it.
单纯的想着去为别人做好事，这个也很好。但是，更好的就是真正的去身体力行的去做事情。所以，更好的就是站起来真去做事儿。
There are people who need help. And if you can help them, you should do it. Don't just think about doing help, but actually do it.
有人需要帮助，所以应该去帮助这些人，而不是仅仅去想着帮助他们，而是要真正的去帮，伸出援手去帮助他们。Thank you。下一个问题是，Govinda Premika，顶拜 Guru 和封建者，念诵时不快乐。感受不到快乐和爱，是不是 Krishna 在远离我们，在远离我们？She's asking that if in the japa, during the japa, I cannot feel love, I cannot feel happiness. Is that that Krishna is far away from us?
No, Krishna is near. He's with you. He's very close, but you're not feeling his presence.
并不是这样的，Krishna 就近在眼前，他和你在一起，他就和你可你很近，但是你没有感受到他的临在。
So you have to chant more.
所以你应该念更多的去念诵的更多。
And you have to call to Krishna that please reveal himself to you.
你可以向 Krishna 呼唤呼喊，请 Krishna 揭示他自己。下一个问题是，Nanda Patni Dadas 是的，确实是少数。问题是现在我们在物质世界，摆脱物质躯体是先决条件。So connect with the previous question that Nanapatni Devdas said it is true that we are minority, but the problem is that now we are living in the material world, so the condition is that the precondition is that first of all we should get rid of the material body.
Well, we can use the material body in the service of Krishna.
我们可以，把这个物质躯体用于为 Krishna 做服务。
If you use everything and the material body is given to us, you can use it for Krishna's service, or you can use it for your own sense gratification. It can be used, it can become spiritual body by using it in the service of Krishna.
就是我们可以，把用一切来做服务，因为这个躯体是给予被赐予我们的。我们可以既可以把这个躯体拿来去服务 Krishna，也可以把这个躯体呢拿来用自己的感官享乐。所以关键是怎么去运用它的问题。当运用它的时候呢，这个躯体就灵性化了，变成灵性的躯体了，就是可以用来服务 Krishna 了。下一个问题是 Harry，顶拜 Guru 和奉献者，什么是纯粹的奉爱服务？怎样更好做纯粹的奉爱服务？What is pure devotional service? How to do better pure devotional service? To
Well,
do
pure
pure.
devotional service means devotional service which is not under the influence of the modes of nature. It's not influenced by ignorance or passion or even goodness. Pure devotional service means it's done simply for the pleasure of Krishna, and it's done constantly and with a favorable attitude.
纯粹的奉献服务就是摆脱了物质自然形态影响的奉献服务，摆脱了愚昧属性、激情属性，甚至善良属性的影响去做服务，而且是只为了 Krishna 的快乐，去做的，并且还要是恒常不断的去从事的，而且还是顺意的，怀着顺意的心态去做的服务。
Rupa Goswami has given the definition of pure devotional service. Anyabhilasita sunyam, yana karma janavritam, anukuyena Krishna nushilanam, bhaktir uttamam. That pure devotional service is performed constantly, continuously for the service of Krishna. It's not done for any material motive, or for The purpose of liberation is performed simply for the pleasure of Krishna.
Rupa Goswami 定义了纯粹的奉献服务。他说，纯粹的奉献服务应当是恒常不断的、持续进行的，是为了 Krishna 的快乐，而且不掺杂着物质的动机，甚至不去渴求解脱，只是为了 Krishna 的快乐从事。
Someone may do devotional service. They think, I want to get rid of my bad karma. So that's not pure devotional service.
有的人从事奉献服务，目的是想要，我想去除我的恶报，那这个就不是纯粹的奉献服务。
Okay.
OK，Prema Vanda Premika Devadasi Hare Krishna，如果弟子害怕上师不敢问问题，因为上师可能生气，而弟子不知道上师生气的原因。这正常吗？If the disciple is afraid of the guru, that the guru may become angry, and the disciple that they are not to ask question, and the disciple doesn't know the reason why the gurus became angry. Is it normal?
No.
This 不正常。
Not usually normal.
不
It's
正
the
常。
duty of the disciple to ask questions to the guru, but he should ask questions which are appropriate. The questions must be in relation to the absolute truth.
弟子有责任，向 guru 上师提出询问，但这些询问必须是恰当的，而且是要和绝对真理有关系的。下一个，Nanda Patni Dadasi，既然灵魂是被关押在地球的，那是 Krishna 关的吗？还是各个星球的？高等文明都有这个权限呢，在我们的 Krishna 知觉里，让我们取悦至尊主，理解上是 Krishna 的意愿，可以这样理解吗？干咕噜。Since the souls are put into the prison house of on the earth, is it done by Krishna? Or
No,
it
it's well, you could say it's done by Krishna, but it's because of the desire of the living entity. The living entity actually desires to come into the material world.
you 也可以这么说，是 Krishna 做的，但是是由于生物体的愿望，因为他们想来到物质世界。
We want to be independent, Krishna.
我们想独立于 Krishna。
So we come into the material world.
所以我们来到了物质世界。She's asking。那我们的 Krishna 世界，in Krishna consciousness, we should please the Supreme Lord。So is this also from is this also the will of Krishna that we should please him?
Yes.
Is 是的，我们取悦至尊主，这是 Krishna 的意愿。
And Krishna wants to please his devotee.
而 Krishna 也想取悦他的奉献者。
Krishna likes to enjoy the loving relationship with his devotee.
Krishna 也喜欢 去享受和他奉献之间的爱心交流。下一个问题，张雪，顶拜孤儿，物质世界有二元性，这年代又充满争斗，封建之间难免有冲突，大多视域不同，角度不同，很难单纯评论对错。作为奉献者，首先要内省自己是否有意挑起矛盾，是否在矛盾发生时，按经典学会化解矛盾，耐心沟通。沟通不清的误会应该学会谦让，暂时选择离开，减少冲突，把误会交给时间。Krishna，我认为奉献者有这样的觉悟，就已经是有足够的 Krishna 直觉。修行应该在日常生活中运用经典的启发。故您说，这对吗？这种理解对吗？So in the material world is duality, and this is the Kali Yoga. And among devotees, there are also conflict unavoidable. Most devotees, they have different vision, different angle of dealing with to do things. And it's a bit difficult to judge who is wrong, who's right. So, as devotees, first of all, we have to introspect ourselves. When there's conflict, first of all, we have to very patiently communicate with others. And as far as the misunderstandings are there, we should be very humble and to be away temporary from those misunderstandings and to let everything to let Krishna to let the time to deal with everything, to get rid of, eliminate those misunderstandings. I think if devotees they have the realization and that is Krishna consciousness, and they during their practice and they have to use the scripture in their daily life. So she want to confirm whether her understanding is right.
Yes, I think it's okay. Yeah, of course, you have to take shelter of the holy name also, you have to chant the holy name. You have to do some sadhana, chanting the holy name every day. That's very important to keep the mind stable and controlled.
那你还得，您说的是的，但你还得托庇于圣明。除此之外，还要托庇于圣明，每天要唱诵圣明，去修习 sadhana，规范修行，这个是非常重要的。唱诵圣明可以让我们很好的控制自己的心意，控制自己的感官，让我们的心意变得稳定。So the next one，这里还有很多问题，there are several more questions。下一个问题，阿玛瓦塔迪达西，请问 Guru 每天做福很机械，对 Krishna 的爱越来越少，怎么办？So, I feel that my service is very mechanical, and I have less and less love for Krishna. So, what to do?
You have to consider what are you doing wrong. You have to look at your life and analyze what are you doing wrong. Are you associating regular with devotees? If you're not associating regular with devotees, then that's a problem.
就你要去做的呢，就是要去审视你的生活，加以分析。分析就是你是不是在和奉献者的联谊？如果没有跟奉献者有规律的联谊，这就是问题了。你要看你生活当中哪个地方做的是错误的。
There's nothing wrong with the process of Krishna consciousness. If you're not developing your love for Krishna, it's not the fault of the process, it's your own fault. It's the way you're practicing that you're not practicing correctly.
Krishna 知觉的程序是没错的，但是你没有发展起对 Krishna 的爱，就错误不在 Krishna 知觉的这个程序，而是在你自己，是你自己修错了。
You have to be, if you're serious to become Krishna conscious, then you have to look and you have to consider where are you going wrong? What are you doing? What are you not doing that you should be doing? For example, maybe you're not chanting enough, or maybe you're not hearing enough, or associating enough.
所以你要好好的去审视你的生活，去考虑哪个地方做错了，看看你到底做了些什么，没做些什么。也许你念诵的不够，聆听的不够，涟漪的不够。下一个问题，the next one, Shita Saki, so the guru。做服务的时候没有想法，只是单纯的去做，对吗？I'm doing a service and I'm simply doing it without any idea, without anything in my mind. Is it right?
Well, we should be thinking of Krishna. We should be thinking, I'm doing this service for Krishna. There should be, remember, do service, yes, but must remember Krishna also.
我们应该想着 Krishna，我们在想着这个服务是为了 Krishna 的。我们应该想着，我们在做这个服务的时候呢，应当一边做着服务，一边想着 Krishna，不是单纯的做服务。下一个问题是，Sachi Lila Devadasi。如何理解帕帕的说"我总是和我的姑妈拉在一起"这句话？我们怎么做才能总是和姑在一起呢？How to understand that Srila Prabhupada said, "I'm always with my Guru Maharaj." And besides, what should we do to be always with our Guru Maharaj always?
Yes, well, when Prabhupada said, I'm always with my Guru Maharaj, it means he's always remembering the instructions of his Guru Maharaj. You associate with the spiritual master, more important is the Vani than the Vapu. So you want to be with your Guru Maharaj, remember the instruction.
当时爸爸的说这句话的时候，意思是说，我们应当总是想着 Guru Maharaj 的训示。你想要谁想要和他和 Guru 联谊的话，应该透过他的 Vani，也就是训示和 Guru 联谊，而不是期待着总是和 Guru 的 Vapu 他的躯体的亲身的联谊。我们想要和 Guru 总是在一起的话，我们就要想着他的训示。Next one 是哈瑞说，什么是 Krishna 的快乐？So, as far as the pleasure of Krishna, please Krishna is concerned, what will please Krishna? What is the happiness of Krishna?
Well, the happiness of Krishna is to see the devotees happy, to see the devotees in Krishna consciousness. Krishna is happy when he sees the devotees surrender to him and give up their material life, give up their material desires, and come to him.
就是 Krishna 的快乐是指的奉献者的快乐，因为奉献者是处在 Krishna 知觉当中的。Krishna 希望看到我们臣服他，放下我们的物质愿望，来到他这里。
Krishna knows we're suffering in the material world. He wants us to come out of this material world and go back to the spiritual world. So he's happy when we go back to him. And he will embrace us and say, "Where have you been? A long time, I didn't see you."
所以，Krishna 不希望看到我们在物质世界痛苦，他希望看到我们脱离这个物质世界，回到他那里，他就会感到快乐，然后紧紧的拥抱我们，说：“你这么长时间，你去哪儿了？”哦，下个问题，PL，马二元性是物质世界的本质吗？Is the duality of the nature of the material world？
Yes.
是的。
Yes, in material world, there's always duality, heat and cold, happiness and distress.
物质冷热苦乐。在物质世界就有着这样的二元性。
Go ahead.
最后一个问题是有关于有规律的涟漪。如果当地每周一次规律成熟的线下联谊，但不参加除了大节，而是在网上服务联谊，这种情况恰当吗？As far as the regular association is concerned，Even there are regular association in the local yatra once in a week, mature association. But if one doesn't participate in the association, except it during the big festival, but instead associate only online and do service online, is it proper?
Well, it's not the best because you can do service online, but often you may, well, you don't get the benefit of the physical presence the same. If you're just associating online, you could be sitting at home and smoking cigarettes and drinking tea and doing service online. Sometimes people are like that. They're listening. They may be listening here this morning, but they're sitting drinking their tea and having cigarettes or whatever. They're not really in very good Krishna consciousness, but they're hearing. And so the same way you can do things online, but you can do them in a much less efficient manner. So it's always good to have physical association.
您说的这种情况不是最好的，因为哪怕是在网上服务，但是也比不上亲身的临在得到的好处。因为一个人可能坐在家里，一边抽着烟啊，喝着茶呀，就在那里听着早课，但他不处在 Krishna 知觉当中去聆听，所以这个效果就没有亲身的联谊来的有效果。Yes,
But
that's
it's
all.
good. Regular service online is also very, very much appreciated, and we do need that service. So that service is appreciated.
那个网上有规律的服务，这是也是非常好的。这种服务是非常受到欣赏的，我们非常欣赏这种网上有规律的服务。
But try also to get physical association.
但是也请这位就有这种情况的奉献者努力的去有线下的亲身的联谊。
Okay.
Yeah，thank you, Maharaj. That's all the question.
我们感谢 Guru Mani Manaji 给我们翻译，感谢所有的帮腔子聆听，我们祝福你们 Dam Damodar Yula。You are quite a Links in the Jinbu, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai, thank you。那我们非常感谢莱昆塔之音服务员聆听，非常非常感谢圣巴克提耶维那维纳什纳辛和马尔给我们带来的精彩的早课，谢谢帕努基的主持，谢谢所有奉献者的参与和聆听，达玛达尔月快乐，Hare Krishna。